Best4Soil. Compost. Practical information. Hi, my name is Alfred Grant. The Best4Soil video tells you about the general definition of compost, as well as the types of compost. You can also see what the benefits from using composts are, and also what challenges you may face when using compost. At the end of the video, you will find additional information on these topics. Please consider watching the other Best4Soil videos on compost and other soil health-related topics. Composted organic matter, or COM, is a product that results from microbial decomposition of organic matter under aerobic conditions. Depending on composting method, size, intensity of the operation, and input material, a large range of composts with different qualities can be produced. Thermophilic compost, also called hot rotting compost, is the most common type of compost product. It can be produced at different scales, from small heaps with manual turning up to tractor-driven or even self-propelled industrial-scale composting methods. Thermophilic compost reaches temperatures of 60 degrees Celsius to 65 degrees Celsius for several days throughout the heap. These temperatures guarantee the killing or deactivation of weed seeds and pathogens in the compost. Vermicomposting is the most natural composting process. It involves epigeic earthworms such as Icena fetida. It is important in this process not to exceed 35 degrees Celsius, otherwise the earthworms can be killed. Vermicompost has the highest diversity of microbes and is considered effective in suppressing some pathogens, but it does not kill or deactivate weed seeds. Therefore, in larger scale production, a combination of thermophilic composting and vermicomposting is recommended. Other composting methods, like field composting or staple composting, are also done in practice. By definition, composting is always done under the influence of oxygen. Therefore, methods which are using anaerobic conditions are not composting, but fermentation methods. Because of the intense tillage and other soil management methods, the organic matter content of our soils have dramatically decreased within the last century. Compost application can significantly increase soil organic matter. Decreased soil organic matter, frequent soil cultivation, pesticides and mineral fertilizer application have resulted in increasing levels of poor microbial diversity. Compost is not only a resource of microbial diversity, but also food and habitat niches for soil microbes. The long-term and continual application of chemical nutrients like nitrogen, phosphorus, and potassium have resulted in a lack of fertility. Compost does contain not only a few main nutrients, but also trace elements and the soil life, which is capable of mobilizing fixed nutrients from the soil. Biodiversity is nature's main asset in fighting the dominance of certain species. As a farmer and producer, you can take advantage of compost to bring back biodiversity into your soils and therefore suppress soil-borne diseases. What are the main challenges for compost production and application? Compost, or even the resources for making compost, are not always available. This problem also extends to the technology for producing and spreading compost. Depending on the area, different regulations for the production and use of compost have to be considered. There is also a risk for bringing contamination like waste debris or heavy metals into the soil with compost. If you want to get more information on compost, feel free to check the Best4Soil website where you can find additional resources.